Hello students and friends, welcome back to my session on SolidWorks in 21 days. We are on day 11. Yesterday we saw about the 3D printing technologies. So with the help of one simple part, I made a part in SolidWorks and I created a STL file with the help of that solid part. Then using the software, I created the G code and M code. Then I got the part 3D printed. In today's session, we'll see about something more on assembly, especially the gears, various types of gears. I'll be solving two different exercises, assembly of two gears, assembly of three gears. Here, I'll try to use equation not only within the part file, also in the assembly. I haven't tried so far. Let me try lively. So if it works, good. Otherwise, maybe in the next session I will be covering that also. But we will try here. Then exporting a drawing file from SolidWorks to the AutoCAD. Okay. So before seeing about the gear, first of all you should know the nomenclatures of the gear. So gear has got number of teeth. If you take your tooth profile, it will be a involute profile actually. But here I am not showing the number of teeth and the involute profile of a tooth. Okay, I am not showing all these things. What I will be showing is the nominal diameter of the gear. Okay, nominal diameter of the gear. So this is equivalent to, it take a thread, M10 thread means, see the nominal dia is 10 mm, nominal dia may be, the metric size is 10 mm, but the nominal dia may be somewhere between 9.5 to 9.7 or something. So that case, you need not show the thread in the nut and thread in the bolt. If the nominal dia is, say for example, for M10, if the nominal diameter is 9.5, for example, 9.5 is that not the exact value, okay, I am taking 9.5 as the example, okay. So that 9.5 is common for both bolt and the nut. With that only we can go to, okay, the gear particular we will see. There is one thing called M. M is nothing but the module. So the module is a nodule formula is D by 10, where D equal to nominal diameter of the gear, T is the number of teeth. So naturally you could see the module will be either in mm or centimeter, because the diameter in the diameter is in the numerator. So if it is m, it will be in mm. If it is in centimeter, it will be in centimeter. Okay, I think it will be in mm only. Okay, I am not very sure. Say, even I know only few information. Whatever information I know, I have with me, I am just sharing those things. Okay, it's not a big mistake actually, right? My idea is make some product, complete some projects. Okay, at times we'll be missing something, no problem. So with these things, we'll create a model now. So exercise number 17, assembly of gears, means I need three items, one file for gear 1, one file for the gear 2, and one for the assembling those two gears in a bracket or in a on a plate. Okay, the second one is generally one gear will be big and one gear will be small. Okay, so the bigger one we normally call as gear, and the smaller one we call it as a pinion. Okay, so instead of saying a gear 1 and gear 2, we can say gear and pinion. Okay, it all based on our convenient only. Okay, now so 17.1 is gear, 17.2 is my pinion, 17.3 is the part that houses the gear and pinion. So let me create a new file, new part file. Okay, this time I'll have a front view as a sketch plane. Let us say this be 40. I already told you that I am not showing the gear profile, gear teeth profile, gear tooth profile actually, right? So instead, what we'll be seeing only a circle. This circle is nothing but the nominal diameter of the gear. So the nominal diameter of this gear and the other gear too, pinion, these two will be contacting, touching at a point. So that should be the condition for the proper meshing of gear and pinion. Okay, we'll have a central hole. Through that only we'll be mounting. That is arrangement. Okay, let this be 5. Then since the gear is a perfect cylinder, you will not you can't see a rotation. For that purpose alone, I am introducing a small hole. With the help of this hole only, you are able to visualize the gear is functioning, a gear is moving. Okay, so the thickness may be 6 or 7, any value. Let me have a separate color for this one. What is the file name? X is number 7. So let me save it as EX17-1. That is a gear. Okay. Then let me save it as 17.2. This is gear, this is okay, let that be pinion, this be gear. Previously that was 40, no? So that was pinion, okay? So this is gear, for example. So here, double that of 1. Instead of 40, it is 80. So that means the gear ratio will be 1:2 or 2:1, whatever it be. So if you have a hole, small hole, a pinhole, then only while rotating, you can see the rotation actually. You can see the rotation. Then we'll this is 80, so diameter is 80, so radius is 40. For the pinion, diameter is 40, so radius is 20. 20 plus 40, okay, 60. I'll be drawing, let me save it as a file number 3 for a slot. On that slot will be, I'll be housing both the gear and pinion, pinion and gear. Let me go for sketch. Let me erase everything. Center slot. Equal, and this is 5 mm. Through that only. Let this be 12 mm or something. Then what is this distance? 20 plus 40, 60. 20 is the radius of the pinion, 40 is the radius of the gear. So 20 plus 40, 60. Let me have a different color. Okay, So now the files are stored. Where is stored actually? Where it is stored? Yeah, 2020. So 17123. Let me open once again. Let me check whether all the three are opened or not. Only 1 and 3 opened. Let me open 2 also. Okay. So if you tile horizontally or vertically, all the three files are there. Okay. In that, these two things should be moving because these are gears, you know. So this should be a fixed members. So for that, what to do? Create a new now we are ready to create. Ready to create and open a assembly file. Escape. Plain white. Now use this insert components dialog box. Through that only I am pinning it. So the three must be a fixed one. So I am choosing three first. Three is copied, and next is the two, the gear, and next is the pinion. Press OK. That's it. Now let us do the mating, assembly mates. This surface and this surface coincident. Okay. And this hole and this hole are concentric. Press OK. This surface, not this surface, this surface. And this surface, I'm sorry. Okay, go to mate. This surface coincident. And this concentric. Now you see the front view. Now let me save it as EX17. Assembly file. So in EX you have these three part files and this assembly file. Let me sort it by name. So that means you'll have all these four here. Okay, the first one is assembly file, the remaining three files are part files. Now you see, okay, now you see, now I can rotate it. See, if this small hole is not there, you cannot see the rotation. That is why I put a small hole. Okay, now actually, again I repeat, in SolidWorks, you need not draw or you need not show the gear tooth or gear teeth profiles. It is enough you to show only the nominal diameter, but these two nominal diameters of this pinion and gear should touch, have a line contact. That is very important. Now we are ready to use the gear mate actually. So what is this one? This diameter is 40, this diameter is 80. Okay, so 40 plus 80, 120 by 2. 60, right? So that then this is 40, this is 80. That means it is 1:2 ratio. So if it rotates twice, this will rotate once, or vice versa. If this rotates once, this will be rotating twice. If it is in clockwise, this will be in anticlockwise. Okay. Now go for mate, one more mate. Now you see independently you can rotate. But if once you introduce a gear, these two will be rotating in unison according to the gear mating principles. So that mate is available under mechanical mates. Even you see under the mechanical mates, cam, slot, hinge, gear, rack and pinion, screw, universal joint, many mates are there. You try. I'll show you only one, and with the help of another file I'll be showing the other thing also, right? So I chose gear. After that, let me choose these two surfaces. So this face and this face. Now you see 40 diameter, 80 diameter, 40 diameter for the pinion and 80 diameter for the gear. So those two are maintained. Press OK, close it. Now if you see that, now you see if you expand this one, gear mate is also included. Gear mate is also included. Okay. Now you see, let me turn this one clockwise twice. This will move in the anticlockwise direction only once. So 1, 2. Now it both the holes, pin holes are meeting. I'll rotate this one. By the time it made this right side gear made half rotation, the pinion rotated once already, 1 RPM. So one rotation completed for the gear, by the time the pinion rotated twice. That is the logic. Okay. I said I haven't tried the equation so far of the assembly. This is the first time I will be trying. Let us see if it works. Good. Otherwise, maybe the next session I can, after learning something, I'll be doing it. Okay. So where is it? Equation. I think I have to use global variables. This under global variable is not accepting. Okay, here D1 sketch 1 of exercise 17-1 part equal to, or we will, okay, we'll go this way. D1 sketch 1 of exercise 17-1 file, this is equal to half of it, you know, so by 2. Okay. At the same time, you have to maintain this one, the center distance between these two, you know, we add that equation, because this is 40, this is 80, 40 plus 80, 120 by 2 is 60. So that is what is maintained here. But we let us introduce the equation for this also. Click this equation. This is equal to, let me put this in bracket, sum of already equation is there, so that is why it is not allowing. What to do? This one, somehow I need this cell also, you know, plus this, I put those things in bracket, those two things in bracket, because those are diameter, no, divided by 2. Shall I put? Yeah, 60. Okay, so diameter of this plus diameter of this within bracket, both are added, divided by 2 means it becomes radius. So you see, this is 60. Now fine, in the first attempt, this is the first time, I admit myself that this is the first time I am trying in the assembly. So now it is globally, because file wise these three are different. Pinion is a separate file, 17-1. Gear is a separate file, part file, 17-2. This bracket housing member is 17-3, a 3-part file. Okay, so let me save. Now equation is added. Okay, now let me say 1/3, 1:3, instead of 1:2, 1:3, let it be. Okay, then let me change 1:3, no, I make it 90. If this is 90, this is 30, or let it be, let me have a different value. So then only we'll see it is this distance will be other than 60. Let this be 81. Now I rebuild this. Now you see everything is automatically resized. This is 81, this is 1/3 of it. So 81 by 3, 27. So 27 plus 81 by 2. Previously it was 60, now it is 54. You got it? Now you see that? Now let me rotate this one. 1, 2, 3. For every 3 revolution, it will make only 1 rotation. Or for every 1 rotation of this, by that time it would have made 3 rotations. Okay, save it. You want to change it to by 2, by 4, 1:4, we'll see. Okay, let it be. So if this is 81 by 4, 20.5, then diameter of these, sum of these two diameters divided by 2, you see what happens? This is, oh, again 54. Okay, so for every 4 rotations, 1, 2, what happens? Yeah, rebuilding is required, sorry. So after rebuilding, control B, now 1, 2, 3, and 4, only at the fourth occasion only both meets. Okay, I'll reset that to 1:2 divided by 2. Let me make it as 80. So 80 by 240. So control B. Oh, sorry. 80, not 80, 8000. Control B. Okay. So everything is as it, now it is as per the 1:2 ratio. It is as per 1:2 ratio. So here we have seen two things. One, assembly of gears. Then using the equation that controls externally, globally, the entities in the parts. Okay, so this is how you can do it. Okay. What I can do is the third file, you know. Okay, so this is sufficient for time being. Let me close all this. Okay, so this is over. Assembly of three gears. Let me use the same pinion and gear. In the bracket, I'll be adding one more slot maybe, right? Here, I did not open the assembly file. So I'll save this file as number four. Then instead of 60, oh, the sketch is it controls that. Okay, let me erase this one. Let me put a central hole that is equal. This distance is 60, means this distance also 60, 120 totally. Okay, now already three files are open with this same three file, but only one bracket is a new file, but old pinion and gear files I am using. Now I am about to create another new assembly file called exercise 18. But for this exercise 18, what I can do is I'll have a different name only for this. Instead of 17.4, I save it as, let me close, rename here, let me rename here 18-4. That is the only difference. Let me open this one. 17, 1 and 2 is common for here, exercise number 17 and 18, right? So assembly file. Let me insert all these things. 18.4 is my fixed part. Then I'm inserting two pinions and one gear. Escape. Okay, go for mate. So I'll be a bit faster maybe. Coincident. Concentric. Coincident. Concentric. Coincident. Concentric. Then side simultaneously at a single stretch, I will be introducing the gear also. Let me put the mating condition between these two now. Condition is made. After that, mating conditions between these two. Made. Done. odd events. So this is rotating, right? Mechanical mate, gear between these two. Okay, now let me save it as EX18. Now if I rotate this one, you see all will be rotating in unison as per the norms. But there will be a slight mismatch, but that mismatch is constant. The mismatch is not varying. So this is clockwise, this is anti-clockwise, this is anti-clockwise, this is clockwise. So this is how you can make why it is again and again exercise 18. Okay, so let me close all this. So again I repeat, for this exercise 17 is the assembly file, for these three are part files and this is the assembly file, this is one set. For this 18, this is the assembly file, this is part 1, part 2, part 3. So 17 minus 1, 17 minus 2 part files are common for assembly of exercise 17 and 18. So that is it. Okay, so let me quickly show you another example that long back I made one SolidWorks assembly, IC engine assembly. Here you could see the gear teeth profiles. Okay. Now if you see, I used concentric distance, gear mates, and cam I used. So many mating conditions I used. Okay, so this will be functioning as per the 4-stroke IC engine principle. Now let me crank the crankshaft. You see, everything will be working as per the norms, as per the specification, as per the definition. You can rotate the gear also, or you can rotate this also. I put a small slot here. Because of this slot only, you are able to see the rotation clearly. So it will be meeting rotation 1, rotation 2. At the same time, the cams will be opening the inlet and exhaust as per the inlet and exhaust four different strokes. Okay, so this is sufficient. Now we'll see how to get a drawing from the SolidWorks drawing file. For that, already we created some drawing files, you know. Let me open that exercise 10 drawing file. In one of the sessions we created solid part and this drawing, right? Okay, so I opened this drawing file, then save as, so it is something like exporting. Save as, you have these many formats. You can save this file as in these many formats. You can save it as JPEG also. Okay, so let me save it as a drawing file. Exercise number 10, drawing file. Okay. Let's check. Yeah, exercise number 10 drawing file has been created. Let me close. I have AutoCAD installed in my system, AutoCAD 7, very old version only. Whether it is automatic AutoCAD 7 or 2020 or 2000, see, line means line, circle means circles, okay? So we do only the basic drafting. So you see, now I am inside the AutoCAD 2007. So I am inside the AutoCAD 7. So you are able to see that. After that, you can do whatever you want here. Okay. So in sometime back we saw we can scribble something here. We can import this drawing file onto the SolidWorks as a sketch. Okay. So I am not creating a separate exercise file for this particular one. Okay. It is quite clear. Open a drawing file, save as DWG. That's it. Very simple. Okay. So with that, I wind up this session. Hope you learnt gear, how to do assembly of a gear. Again, gear means, again, gear, you need not show the gear teeth and all. The nominal diameter circle is sufficient for any number of gears, whether it is a pinion 1, gear 1, gear 2, pinion 2, anything. Well and good. Okay. So subscribe my channel. If not, if you have already subscribed it, I'm happy. So inform this to others. Let them also gain some knowledge on SolidWorks from my sessions actually. Okay, thank you.